Welcome to our conversation. It's a pleasure to have you with us today. And we wanted to have your insights on what has been happening in the recent few months. And I'm looking forward to getting your thoughts on what has been occurring to family businesses in specifically in Tunisia and in the region in general. So welcome to our conversation.
Thank you.
So, Mr. Bouchamaoui, maybe you can just briefly introduce yourself and your family business so that we have a bit of a better understanding of your own career and your family business.
Sure. My name is Anis Bouchamaoui. I've been in the family business for 20 years now, mostly in the oil business, starting from agriculture to oil business services, from downstream to upstream. And we diversified a little bit of our businesses to real estate services, big part of it to the oil services. And we're getting now onto the renewable energy.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a small summary of our businesses.
And when did you join the family business? And what was your trajectory a little bit throughout these years?
I studied petroleum engineering. And as soon as I started with the company, it was practically from the field for the drilling, for the construction. I had some training in two NOC companies before. And then I tried to climb a little bit from to see other aspects of the company, mostly in the logistics, procurement area, and then the finance.
So you've had a very diverse career already in your family business. So that's quite impressive. So from all those experiences coming to today, where we stand at the moment, so we've just experienced this global pandemic, this health crisis, basically. And I was wondering if you could explain to us a little bit what the reaction or what the impact has been for family businesses in Tunisia.
So no person has been immune from this pandemic. It has been very struggling moments for companies, business companies in Tunisia, as nobody was prepared for that.
Yeah.
I mean, we are still learning from that experience, for sure. The Tunisian economy has been struggling for a moment since the revolution in Tunisia in 2011. And companies were not prepared yet for the development. And this was a big hit, I think, for the business families. But, I mean, what we can learn from that experience is that it helped companies. There was a bond between the government and the companies. And
right.
We see there is a big collaboration today between the companies and the government.
How interesting.
I mean, the good experience. And our government has been put in place like before, like 2 weeks. It was in the beginning of March, the beginning of the pandemic in the wall in Tunisia, let's say. And it was very hard moment for the government. And they had to do the lockdown like 2 weeks after they took power. And it's a very big hit for the government. But I think the reaction was very good reaction from the government.
Okay.
They put some insights for the companies and for the public companies, and also insights for the people who needed assistance and help.
Right.
So, I think it has been a good experience to put a collaboration together between the
public and the private sector. So do you feel that it was a bit unexpected, perhaps, how good the private and the public sector worked together then?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, there are some interesting experiences that happened between private sectors and public sectors, and also between competitors in the private sector.
Okay.
We've seen that some competitor companies have been alike to assist each other in different aspects, like if there is a demand for a product that is not found on one company, the other company could provide it. And that was a good and interesting experience for that. And I think we learned from that.
Absolutely. I think that's a very, we've seen that a little bit in other countries as well, that specifically family businesses, let's say, even though they were competitors, but they've known each other for so long, there are social ties between them. So they have direct connections with each other that they are actually helping each other out or connecting in different ways. So I find that a very interesting response, basically. So during that emergency time, that there are ways to connect together to help each other out. So now that we've kind of left the immediate emergency response behind us, right? So I would say now it's been about 3 months for most of us. I think companies have started adjusting a little bit to this new reality. And I believe we see now family businesses starting to realize the mid long-term effects of what has been happening. So do you see that there is a dialogue within the Tunisian business community to try to understand the impact of this and the extent of this crisis?
I mean, we are still learning from that experience. Everybody's still learning. And, yeah. And what I noticed is that, good communication between different entities, business entities in Tunisia. And as you said, family businesses that are tied together to try to get strategies, because there is no, not a normal procedure, to follow. Yeah. And we've seen that in the whole world, but we're trying every part from its side, to make their procedure and try to learn from our experiences and see how we can move forward after this recession.
Yeah. And so do you feel that family businesses will be playing a key role in the recovery phase? And why do you think family businesses might be important in this phase? What are the attributes that they have that non-family businesses don't have?
Okay, family businesses, they take a very big important part in Tunisian economy, mm-hmm. in different sectors. And let's say in family businesses, it's easy to make decisions and move mm-hmm. forward. And that's the big strength that we can have. There are some adjustments that have to be made. And as we know, like the biggest disadvantages of family businesses is communication. And today, communication is a very important part.
Yes.
And we have to move on that part to communicate with the different stakeholders and between the different stakeholders. The other important thing, if we may come back on that, and I think for this period of lockdown, a lot of companies have tried to adapt with the IT technology so everybody can be connected everywhere. The other thing that we've been talking a lot about is today we don't know how long we are back from lockdown. We may have another lockdown, so everybody has to be prepared on that side. And this is something that has been the subject that was in the communication between different entities.
Mm-hmm. If we look at the internal organization in family firms, there is a tendency in family firms sometimes to live in a sort of a comfort zone when it comes to how they take decisions, right? At some point, you find kind of the magic formula that works. And very often, we don't really review that. We work with it. And so perhaps decision-making or governance structures sometimes become a bit, let's say, old-fashioned and perhaps a bit traditional with regards to the future. Do you feel this situation will lead to family firms restructuring or reviewing their internal mechanisms?
I'm confident that it will lead to change. We need to do that for sure. And these are points that we discussed a lot. It's corporate governance, restructuring. These are subjects that we talk about a lot, but it's very hard to implement on the family businesses, especially, let's say, in Tunisia right now. So these are things that we tend to do, yeah.
Yeah. So are there some points that you can recommend to other family businesses, perhaps based on the experience that you've had in your own family business throughout, let's say, the last 3 months of this situation, but also with regards to the future planning? What are some of the first learnings or takeaways that you would like to give to other family businesses going through the similar situation?
I think the most important thing is communication. We did learn that, from this experience, we communicate a lot between the different family members, board members, with the management. Mm-hmm. I mean, there was a big involvement of the family members on the day-to-day business. And I think it's very important in this crucial time to be on top of most of the subjects that need rapid decisions and the right decisions.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing from our side, I mean, we try to communicate a lot with the employees.
Yeah.
And this is an important part for the family business, is have the employees feel like they are in a family and that they are not live by themselves. We try to ask about how safe they are, how they, even in the periods of lockdown,
mm-hmm.
we try even to see what concerns they have. And I think this is a new thing that has to be taken in importance for the family businesses, because it's a new world that we're living in, and they need to have the support from their companies. And
yes.
There are a lot of employees that they don't know what's their future would be, because and we need to communicate a lot with them about that point.
Of course.
I think this is the most important thing that has to be taken care of from the beginning, because the employees are the core of the company. Yeah.
Of course, yeah. And also, of course, they will be very important to the success in the future. Because if you lose key talent in a crisis, to rebuild that resource is going to be very, very difficult and costly and take a lot of time. So I fully agree with you. And I believe that what we've seen across the region is a very similar response in other family businesses, that they really place a lot of emphasis on their people and on their teams to make sure, of course, because they are part of the wider family, but also because there is a very strategic reason to make sure that your teams stay intact in order then to move forward. So definitely that's a very good takeaway to take with us. But thank you so much for this interview, Mr. Bouchemaoui. It's very interesting to understand a bit more how the Tunisian situation is, how family businesses in Tunisia are facing this. And we thank you for your insights.
Thank you for your time. Thank you for it.